Here we are at the Angry Orchard in Detroit, where the Detroit Dingleberries will take on the Ottawa Valley Island Boys. Almost said Puck Slappers, forced to have it. In our first inaugural Central Division match of Season 13. It's the first time we've hosted the Central Division, and it will be a historic night for whichever team comes out on top. It's the first ever. Let's see what they got. Already filing into the lobby. Look at them go. They're ready for it here in Central. Cobra, River, Black Woman Lover in the lobby. Black Woman Lover just coming off a game here in for his IM team. Did not quite fall their way, but they did put on an immense amount of pressure on the defense of the opposition. And if tonight's game is going to be any determining factor of it, I think Detroit's going to be throwing everything they can at the opponent, seeing what sticks, seeing what doesn't. I think it's going to be a fun one. I think it's going to be a tight one. I don't think there's going to be much left on the table for either of these teams. I don't have a graphic prepared for this, but this is what basically what the SPL structure looks like. It just doesn't have the prospect division. We have the A, B, C, and the D division for our central division. Of course, A is pro, B is challenger, C is IM, and then D would be considered our open division for the central structure. So this would be the second highest division for the boys across the pond. I guess in the middle of the pond, really, because it's just the middle of America. Yeah. But yeah, that's what we got going on here tonight. So it's the second highest in the Central. We'll see what they got going on. Here's the roster for tonight's matchup for the visiting team, the Ottawa Valley Island Boys. Eggstink, the captain, once more. Broba Gerda, the defensive mind, the defensive master of stopping the puck. He's going to be called on here tonight. He is going to be challenged by this team. He's going to be demanded for saves through this entire 15 minutes of slap shot. Whether or not he can output is going to be whether or not Ottawa Valley can win. I think Need Staff is going to be also out there on the ice. They got a good roster. Eggstink, Broba Gerda, I think Vice, all an IM player. I think that's not a very big stretch to say that. Slippin' Johnny playing in Challenger this season. We saw him earlier tonight with our Challenger matchup. Need Staff playing in Open. It's been a long time since Need Staff has been in SPL. I have missed him dearly. Love Need Staff. It's been a while since he's played. I feel maybe it's just because I see his name everywhere a long while ago that Extinct just DM'd me. Please don't tell me the game's canceled. He's saying thank you for casting. Thank God. Oh, my heart dropped. I thought we were going to have this third game. Oh, this has happened so many times. I'm just having PTSD thinking about it. Black Woman Lover is on two teams. So there's three regions in SPL. There's the West, the Central, and the East. You can play on one team per region. So this is a different league structure than the main SPL. Main SPL are like the... We just showed it. Hang on, let me just go back. It'll be easier to explain this way. We have Pro, Challenger, IM, Prospect, and Open. That's all of our Eastern divisions. So that's all one league structure. You can only be on one team in these five divisions at a time. Central is different. We have the A, B, C, and D. That's all one structure. You can only be on one team through those four divisions at a time. And then West is just, I think it's just one division this season. We have eight teams over there. So you can only be on one West team at a time. So that's how Black Woman Lover is on two teams in the same broadcast. It's going to take some getting used to. I hope Central sticks around for a while. I think it's going to be more inclusive, more down to earth. I think I'm more excited for Central this season than I am East. I don't know what it is. It's just the vibes around it are different. The team composition is different. They're not all out there to be the best. They're all out there to play with people that they wouldn't get to play with otherwise. And I respect that. I respect that immensely. Like Pacer Fitness Test would never be on a team with Flaccid Lettuce and Tea if it was not for the Central Division or the Central Region. But this season is possible. I'm very excited to see what they do. I hope I catch every one of their games if they update the website, which has been a very ongoing battle whenever it comes to dealing with captains and team managers. It's just making sure the casters are notified of when the games are happening. Apparently, it was a pro game tonight. I didn't know anything about it. The website did not reflect that information to me at all. But a game that did reflect information to me was this one. So I got another minute or so to burn before this one gets underway. I've been trying to do better with my ad placements for this broadcast. Let me know if it's working out, if you guys like it, don't like it. I've been trying to make sure there's no pre-roll ads during the games by running ads after the game has concluded. We're in like the intermission screen where it's just, what game's up next? What music's playing? Haha. Like that screen is very, you don't need that. You really, it's not important to the stream. Let me know, give me some feedback. I'm very excited to see what's going on here tonight. Dingleberries. Not the best logo, but it is a logo, and I would appreciate that much more than no logo, because there's a pro team right now that doesn't have a logo. So I appreciate that teams all through the league structure are willing to put in time and money sometimes and get themselves a brand. I also love the Island Boys logo. I don't think it's the best. I think it's solid, though. Humu Humu Nuku Nuku Apua A logo there on the left of the background screen. That's my favorite logo. I got a hoodie with that logo on it. I think it's the only SPL merch I actually have is the Humu Humu Nuku Nuku Apua A hoodie that I bought off Deli Meat back in season 1, 2, something like that. Yeah, X-Think, Bubba Gerda joining the lobby for Ottawa Valley. Detroit having their 3 because they have to play the game. That's all I got for you. There's not much in the Nugget Knowledge Cavern for this matchup. There's not any history between these teams. There's not really much to go over. There's not a whole lot to kind of gloss over when it comes down to this, because there's no history. We're writing the history right now. Thank you. This is Mike Tyson punch out. Maybe it's the Wii. It's Disco Kid. If you want to look it up. Big fan of all of the Punch-Out songs. They got a good vibe. Make me feel like I can cat jam in IRL. How's it going, Bueller? Hope you're having a great day. Thank you, Joe Eggman, for the sub. Hope you're having a great day as well. I got your back. Joe, if you don't have your Twitch and Discord linked, if you go into Discord and link your Twitch, you now have a part owner role in SPL. You can flex on all the plebeians. Spills is a baby gamer. Says Spills Slapshot. I like that. The mods here, can you pin that? All right, 6 ready to rock, 6 ready to roll. We're down to the ice. Ottawa Valley on the left side of your screen in the orange. And on the right side, we have the Detroit Dingleberries in the red. The puck has dropped, the game is on, and time is underway for the first time here tonight in the first. Black Woman Lover getting a hand on this one off the back, and a shot made, a better save there by the Ottawa Valley defense. Zone goes out towards the neutral zone, not able to get it all the way through. Cobra getting a hand on this. I think we changed their color to black in the intermission. I feel slightly colorblind looking at the red and orange and trying to differentiate. Black Woman Lover near side, out of the reach of Snot. Robo Gerda picking that one back up towards Black Woman Lover. Top side over to Cobro. Cobro here with the now, trying to get this one past Needstaff. Needstaff almost able to get the puck to work with him, but it just didn't. It wasn't about it. It really just wasn't about it. It was like a homeschooler out of the high school prom. It just wasn't happening. Here's Cobro. Stopped there by Robo Gerda. Sends this one off the near side, soaring out to Needstaff off the back end. Good try on the whip. Stopped there by Black Woman Lover. Off the back end. Through the hands of Snot. Bubba Gerda here. The now longtime defenseman here for Ottawa Valley. Back with the puck slappers. Captain the stick slappers last season. Almost able to find a shot there. Slipping Johnny, the Portsmouth former captain. Down there on the ice. Almost able to find the first goal in the central season. Nice shot. Better save. Off the back end. And out it goes. What a save by Bubba Gerda. Slipping Johnny wins the stick checking battle. Here's Bergerda with a now. Looks towards the near side of the ice, swings that one out to the neutral zone. Here's Snot with an out. Off the backhand, stopped there by Bergerda. Thrown back into the defensive end of Detroit. Near side wall over to Cobro. Looking for an alley-oop back out to the point. Here's Snot with an out. Off the forehand to Cobro. Off the forehand. Stick check there by the defense. Off to the top side, the wraparound attempt goes off the Black Woman Lover. Always able to find his way towards the back of the brain bucket. A great defense. Hugging the top side post for dear life, keeping the puck out. Ottawa Valley still keeping the score the same. It's not getting a piece of this one. Near side, down the straight, trying to find a backhand feed. Nice save by Bubba Gerda. Out back between the pipes, standing tall, standing mighty. Not going to be fazed by a shot like that. He sends that one off the back wall.
Black woman lover sent back over to Snot back in the defensive zone. Looking top side over to Cobra. Holds, shoots near side off the post, and that one rings wide. Here's Bergerda with a shot attempt. That one defended at the blue line by Snot. Snot top side. Goes off to Cobra. Cobra back to the point. Snot here picking it up. Trying to get this one past. Needs staff off the back end. Shooting, scoring. Top right 90. Five tries into the game. They finally found a way to break through the absolute brick wall. Back on defense. Good stuff. Good stuff. 1-0 on the board. 2:43 to go here in the first. Boys in red getting on the board hot. Getting on the board pretty early. It's not. Looking top side. Looking to bring this one down and around town. Fans on the jive back center. Need staff getting a piece of that one to free that one up here. Snot with it now. Off the forehand. Hits almost a Jabu pass. I haven't seen that in quite some time. I love it. Great flair. I think that's what SPL needs is more of that. Give us the flair. Give us the oomph. Give us the chutzpah, if you know what I'm saying. Slipping Johnny. Trying to find a centering feed here. Snot with it now. Reba Gerda. Down in the corner, trying to find a way to lob that one over Snot. Gerda going off Snot, goes topside. Black woman lover here with it now, looking to hit that diagonal pass. Slipping Johnny knows it too well. Great way to slide up, take away that ability to have that passing lane. Bergoda. Getting a piece of that one. Snot has the ability, just takes it, holds it, pops it, pows it. And it's 2-0. Not a fortuitous bounce. I don't think that was what was intentional. Sometimes slap shot is a slap shot does, and you just kind of hope the slap shot bounces in your favor. Hockey got Jeremy. Might have been angry. Ottawa Valley didn't quite have the here slipping Johnny. Nice shot, not able to go in. I think Hockey got Jeremy. He's just not about it here tonight. They're wearing orange. Orange is not his favorite color. And I think that's really all the reasoning he needs to give the bad puck luck to the Ottawa Valley Island boys. Pagoda on the top side wall, trying to get this one off. Court slipping Johnny out in front of your Snot. Stop there by Need Staff. Trying to get that one through the upright. Snot there taking it away. Forehand pass goes off Bergoda. Top side. Able to find that save and the puck back down into the Detroit zone. Your Snot with it now. 56 seconds remaining here in the first period. Cobra bank pass to himself. Off slipping Johnny with that block. He'll start this breakout for the boys in orange. Leading pass to Bergoda. Leading him far into the O zone. He doesn't like that a lot. He's a man. That's about his simple things. He's a simple man. He loves blocking the shots. That's what he's known for. It's what he's made his life goal. It's like that one commercial. I'm sure everybody that's watched the NHL knows it. You got no goals. Thoughts about retirement? No goals. Thoughts on slap shot? No goals. He's a simple man. I'm about it. 20 seconds to go. Topside Cobra here. Backhand. Forehand shooting. Not able to get that one to go. Bergoda. Look at topside. Cobra getting a piece of that one. 10 seconds remain. Goes over to Black Woman Lover. Dangling. Nice stick check there by Need Staff. Keeps the scoring opportunity to a minimum. Black Woman Lover gets a step. Tries to get fancy with it. Didn't release it. And that'll be the end of the first period. 7 shots, 2 goals. Detroit, the only one on the board so far here tonight at the Angry Orchard. The home team giving the home crowd something to cheer for here tonight. So they are the favorite according to the channel points. 60% going in their favor. And so far here tonight, Ottawa Valley just have to find a way to get something going on offense. I think Egg Stink needs to come in for Need Staff, and that will happen. But Slipping Johnny, 1 save. Broba Gerda, 4 saves out of the team's total of 5. And their takeaway ratio, not great. Their possession game, very in favor of Detroit. Snot hitting 2 shots here tonight out of his 4. That's really the only difference maker on the scoreboard here tonight. But second period, ready to rock, ready to roll. We got 6 down on the ice, already warm. Egg Stink sitting on the bench for a little bit. During that first period, we'll see if that has any effect going into this one. Only time will tell. Detroit defends right in the red. Ottawa Valley defends left side in the orange. Cobra getting a hand on this one. Rover Gerda. Looks near side from the corner. Starts the breakout. Black woman lever to Cobra. Empty net. And he's got a score. You don't pass that one up. Great pressure at the blue line. Cobra sitting all alone, sitting pretty out in front of the crease. Slipping Johnny read the play a little too slow. That left him open a little too long. Black woman lover, forehand shot. Broba Gerda standing tall with a save. They dump that one back down into the Detroit zone. Eggs think the captain going to be forcing him to pick a side. Snot there with a big pass to himself. A panhandle. Love it. Nice. He's a man of mechanics. He reminds me a bit of Valo a little bit. I don't know if you guys remember that. But Valo was a man. That was all about the mechanics. Didn't matter what you were mentally. He was hitting panhandles. He was hitting jabu shots. Robigerda pressing the issue on the top side blue line. Gets this one down low. Stopped at the outer slot by Cobro. Makes think there to try to help out. Robigerda, last man back. Great idea. Great thought process there. Keeping that one from being an odd man rush out the other way. Robigerda, nice steal. Not able to get the shot on target, though. That one goes down low. There will be a rebound down to the near side thanks to slipping Johnny to Eggstink. Back to the point. Robigerda sent into the corner. Eggstink off the back end. Not able to get that one past Snot from the end wall. Finds his way over the stick. Hitting a panhandle. And that one almost going in. Oh, man. That's as close as you can get to being an unfortunate mishap. Cobro. Stick checked away there by Robigerda. Looks near side. Stopped there by Black Woman Lover. From the corner. They battle it out at the end wall. Slipping Johnny. Tries to give his boy some time to breathe. Goes off the backhand. Shot by Eggstinks. Defended wide there by Snot in the neutral zone. Snot down into his own end wall. Looks down center lane. And Slipping Johnny able to crack a few eggs to make an omelet here tonight. Two goals the gap. Their first goal of the season. Coming from a great position and a great takeaway. Slipping Johnny does not miss those more times than not. 1-3 our score here with 3:05 to go in the second. Snot. Robigerda out in front. Dangerous turnover. Here's Black Woman Lover out of the blue line. Shooting. What a save. Oh, my goodness. I'll eat my hat. What a way to shut him down from the blue line. Pushed through the stick checking on the forecheck and found a way to get in position for the block. 2:39 to go here in the second. Slipping Johnny here with the puck now. Plays Portsmouth here on the east side of the SPL. Black Woman Liver getting a piece of this one. Forcing this one northway. Stick check, and he still finds a way to get back to save it. Mr. Dominic Hasek back there. He wants his phone number. Cobro. Led with that pass. Has to come back for it. Down in the corner. Slipping Johnny takes it away for the boys in orange. Off the backhand. Over to Eggstink. Eggstink down low. Looks for Slipping Johnny once more. Stick check by Cobro. Black Woman Lover not able to take it away neither. Centering feed in the air. Eggstink not able to take that one away. Cobro sends this one topside for a lengthy pass to Black Woman Lover. Not able to find it there after the day. He's playing with fire right now, but he's not getting burned. He knows what he's doing. He's a pyromancer back there. Robigerda still with the puck. Off the forehand. Back down low. Stick checked away by Cobra, but he's not going to give up. Here's Slipping Johnny. Near side. Robigerda off the backhand. Shooting. Far side and wide. Here's Snot. 3-1 our score. Detroit still in the lead. Here's Cobra. Backhand pass. Wanted to get fancy with it. Did not want the empty net. He wanted the style points for it, and I respect that. Slipping Johnny down low here for Ottawa Valley. Near side over to Eggstink. Off the backhand. Hits the end wall. Snot getting a piece of that one. Robigerda top side. Looks for the pass down low to his captain. Not able to get through the defense of Detroit. Here's Eggstink with it now. One trailing three. Trying to get this one down low to get that one closer. Snot here with the puck now for Detroit. 1:12 to go in the second. Bank pass over to Cobra. Cobra centering feed. Black Woman Liver. Fans on it. Comes back for it. And he shoots. Scores. And he finds a way. The first one did not succeed. Slipping Johnny got caught reaching. Robigerda got back in time to force the fumble. Slipping Johnny getting a piece of it. Just not quite the angle he needed to get that one out of the crease safely. 60 seconds remain here in the second. 4-1 our score. Detroit getting the majority of scoring chances so far here tonight. Out shooting their opponent 12-1. You just got to hit the net. Ottawa Valley just has to hit the net. That's the only difference they got to make from here to then. Black Woman Lover here picking it up. Looks down towards the near side. Goes off the hip of Eggstink over to Cobro. Cobro here taking it through the neutral zone. Pass over to Snot. Beautiful save by Robigerda. Eggstink backhand down low. Slipping Johnny picks it up back to the point. Robigerda off the hands of Snot. Oh no. It took a few whacks of the stick, but it found its way through. Man, 2-on-1, back at the defensive. It's just on the post the whole time. There's nothing Robigerda could have done. It's just, it was faded by the stars. You're standing on the goal line, trying to fight one man, a second guy comes in. What are you going to do? There's just nothing you can do. Snot takes it at the point. Looking to get one more shot on target. Will not be allowed it, thanks to the defense of Ottawa Valley. And it's 1-5 now. Bro Bagerda has been getting hung up to dry a little bit here in that second period. I think the Eggs thinks subbing has greatly factored into the amount of pressure they've been able to supply. I think the possession time was 20 seconds. This period, they got 47, roughly. They're turning it around. They got a goal on the board. They're down 1-5. This is very comebackable. Six players ready to rock. Six players ready to roll. If you want to see the individual stats, here they are. We're back down on the ice. If my OBS will do the thing. Thank you. Ottawa Valley defends left side in the black. Detroit defends right side in the red. Third period of action is underway. It's not looking near side. Stopped by Bro Bagerda. Switching up the fit. I like it. Trying to get a different headspace, to get a different aura down there on the ice. Looking a lot like, I think, are those the Spills eyes? I don't know. It feels like a very Spills fit. I don't know why it is. Black woman lover off the backhand, shooting far side and wide. Here's Bro Bagerda, top side, down low, slipping Johnny out to the Eggs thing. Not able to take it on the backhand pocket. It caught it on the hip instead. Just not quite able to finagle with it and sneak that one by him. Black woman lover off the tip of his stick, goes off the corner, goes top side. Outer slot, here's Snot. Goes off the hip on the deflection of slipping Johnny on that cross ice pass. Here's Cobra down low for Detroit, trying to further the efforts of the offense. Bro Bagerda goes off slipping Johnny here in the neutral zone transition. Black woman lover taking that one back away, knocked loose. Snot here with an out for Detroit. Goes top side from the slot. Nice save, and that one's going to be cleared off the forehand. Black woman lover able to get a hand on it, not able to take possession. Snot takes it away for Detroit. Off the backside of his own cage, finds his way topside, finds a lot of elbow room on that backhand jive down to the near side. I think Eggs think was just out of stims, I was going to say. It's sprints, dashes. It's not. Back to Black Woman Lover from the corner. Not able to get that one past slipping Johnny. He's not going to be slipping on that one. He slips on that one, though. His topside, Snot finds it, backhand shooting, scoring! And he makes it 6-1. And out go the Hats for the hat trick. They were so close to that one catastrophically not happening. There was like three things that if it was just a few frames different, a few inch difference, that play would not have happened. But here we are at 6-1. Very small area of succession on that offensive drive. But it pays out. That's all that matters. That's the second shot on the board for Ottawa Valley here this game. There's 3 minutes left in regulation. We played 12 minutes of slap shot. They have two shots. They just got to find a way to throw the puck on target. That's all they have to do. That's all they need to do. That's all they got to be thinking about. Anywhere they're on the ice, get the puck there. Black woman lover deflected there by Bro Bagerda. They have not been given a lot of opportunity. The back check of Detroit has been immense here for Ottawa Valley. Anytime they have the puck, there's just a red jersey there. They have been given no room to work with. Eggs think off the backhand. He's going to throw that one in. He's going to give himself a moment to breathe. Just an inhale. One singular inhale. What a save by Bro Bagerda. And he's the only reason it's not 18-2. He's the only reason. Snot looking for the jive down center lane. Goes off Bro Bagerda once, twice. The stick check battle won. Back away over towards Eggsthink. Eggsthink trying for the diagonal pass to slip, and Johnny not able to get its way through cleanly. Bro Bagerda comes back to help his teammate out. Cobro forcing that one loose down center lane, not able to find his way out in favor of Ottawa Valley, hoping for the boys in orange to find at least one more goal before the end of this game. Slipping Johnny off the backhand. It's a challenge there by Snot, going to force that one through the wickets, and that one's just going to be run all the way back, Hope, and it's 7-1. I don't think, being the sports analyst I am, I don't think it's a stretch to say that this is not ideal for Ottawa Valley. They came out. This is the first game of the season. It's going to be a long season. Everybody plays everybody twice in this 8-team division. Top six make playoffs. Nice shot by Bagerda. Oh, he's beautiful. He had a chance. He's like, oh, I can hit the net from here. How about that? That's crazy. Does he have both? There's no way. No, he doesn't. All right, Slippin' Johnny has the other one. It's been a while. It's just nice save by Bagerda. Looking near side. Trying to throw that one down low. Snot here picking it up. So two games in a row. Black Woman Lovers team here on SPL Net. We casted Black Woman Lovers IM game earlier against Kowtown Noxus team. They had 20 shots that game. This game, 20 shots as well. They're just throwing it at the net. If it sticks, it sticks. If it doesn't, it doesn't. 20 shots, 7 goals. Nice shot off the body. In it. Oh, no, it doesn't go in. It's out in front still. They're battling. They're throwing sticks at it. They're throwing everything they can at that net. Nothing stuck. I can't believe it. Snut says, I'm a tank. Oh, my goodness. Just a defensive onslaught. Was it 3-on-1? There's no way. My goodness, they just threw out everything except they threw the baby out with the bathwater. I don't think that's how the saying goes, but that's how it feels right now. Bergodas doesn't score. It was Eggstink. Stolen Valor. Somebody ban him. Get him out of the league. Get him out of here. 29 seconds to go here in the third. 3-7 our score. And another one. Brovacurta. He's just finding a way. I think this is the rock that makes or breaks Ottawa Valley. There might be a whole roster down there, but that one man's done a heck of a job here tonight. It's not. Bank pass down low. Black Woman Lover out in front. Cobra going to sink that one down with a battleship. Throwing that 4-goal difference back up on the board. Says, when this is all done and over, nobody's watching the VOD. Everyone is looking at the stats, and they're going to see that goal. And they're going to think about that one for at least a nanosecond. 10 seconds remain here in regulation. 8-4 our score. Detroit on top and looking to stay that way. Tipping Johnny taking it away. He'll just hold on to it for the end of the match. What a game. What a start to this Central season here in Central B. Great game. Great matchup. I feel a little bad for Neat's staff. I feel like the skill level is a little above his head here. I think he'll have at least one or two equal matches during the regular season, so I'm hoping for that. But regardless, 8-4 our final score here at the Angry Orchard. Detroit undefeated on home ice here in Season 13. We'll see if it stays that way. 12 shots, 8 of them going in for Detroit. 7 shots for Ottawa, 4 of them finding their way through the posts. And what a defensive game. 11 saves out of the team's 13. Brovacurta also has the most goals with 2. Slipping Johnny Eggstink both getting 1 for the total of 4 here tonight. The possession game is very lopsided. I think that's a determining factor here tonight. Their opponent almost tripled their possession time. That timer only starts when you have the puck alone. Nobody can touch you. It's just you and the puck and a spaghetti dinner. And you're just hoping that you get the same noodle. I don't know. Black Woman Lover, 3 goals. Snot, 3 goals. Cobra with 2. Snot having all 3 saves for the Detroit Dingleberries with the most possession time in the lobby with a 1:49. Great stuff out there for the Detroit. Great stuff out there for Ottawa Valley. But that will do it here tonight for our broadcast. It was a fun time. I had a great idea. You see that? That's Slapshot. That's what Slapshot does to a man. You see it? You like it? You think about it? You're nerding on it? I don't know, man. I'm ready for bed. But thank you for hanging out. Thank you for watching some good old-fashioned Slapshot with me here tonight. There's 30 of you here. I'm glad I don't have the viewer number up during the broadcast. Knowing that there's more than my mom watching makes me nervous. It's just the way that it is. I'm sure that Mike Lang would feel the same way. That last push from Ottawa Valley, I don't know how they didn't score from that. I think if you put any other team out there except for Detroit, that turns out to be a goal. There's no way. There's no two ways about it. It's insane. But thanks for hanging out. Thanks for all the support. Joe with a sub. Thank you for that. Fuico going 5 months strong says RAR. Hope you're having a great day as well. And all the big names in red. Irvion, Eli, JSTronics, Minnesota, Gubby, M-Dub, Unglued Snail, Manny, Q, Silver, Laughtrack, Davo, and Cheese Pup. Thank you all. Top gifters, top supporters of the SPL network. All the money that goes into this channel, realistically, it just all goes back into like funding for the website and running this league. So all the money you give me, sometimes I use it. Sometimes I have to like fix something that is essential to SPL's operation. But other than that, it's mostly just website funding. But day one in the books. Everybody got a few licks in. Tomorrow, Season 13 continues on here in week one. We'll see how it goes. But for now, thank you for tuning into the SPL Network. My name is Darth Texil. I hope you all have a great afternoon, a great evening, and a great night. Hoorah.
One, two, three, 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 one, two, three,